the most recognizable scientist of our age, Hawking holds an iconic status. His genre-defining book, A Brief History of Time, has sold more than 10 million copies since its publication in 1988, and has been translated into more than 35 languages. He appeared on Star Trek, The Next Generation, The Simpsons and The Big Bang Theory. His early life was the subject of an Oscar-winning performance by Eddie Redmayne in the 2014 film The Theory of Everything. He was routinely consulted for oracular pronouncements on everything from time travel and alien life to Middle Eastern politics and nefarious robots. He had an endearing sense of humor and a daredevil attitude, relatable human traits that, combined with his seemingly superhuman mind, made Hawking eminently marketable. Today we will discuss the extraordinary life of Stephen Hawking, who, despite battling a debilitating disease, became one of the most celebrated physicists of our time. Stephen William Hawking was born on January 8, 1942, in Oxford, England. He studied physics at the University of Oxford, where he received his bachelor's degree in 1962. Hawking's research career began with disappointment. Arriving at the University of Cambridge in 1962 to begin his PhD, he was told that Fred Hoyle, his chosen supervisor, already had a full complement of students. The most famous British astrophysicist at the time, Hoyle was a magnet for the more ambitious students. Hawking didn't make the cut. Instead, he was to work with Dennis Sciama, a physicist Hawking knew nothing about. In 1963, at the age of 21, Hawking was diagnosed with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ALS, a motor neuron disease. Doctors initially gave him a very limited time to live. Despite his diagnosis, Hawking continued his studies and earned his PhD in theoretical physics from the University of Cambridge in 1966. Although Hawking's body may have weakened, his intellect stayed sharp. 2 years into his PhD, he was having trouble walking and talking, but it was clear that the disease was progressing more slowly than the doctors had initially feared. Meanwhile, his engagement to Jane Wilde, with whom he later had three children, Robert, Lucy and Tim, renewed his drive to make real progress in physics. Working with Sciama had its advantages. Hoyle's fame meant that he was seldom in the department, whereas Sciama was around and eager to talk. Those discussions stimulated the young Hawking to pursue his own scientific vision. Hoyle was vehemently opposed to the Big Bang theory. In fact, he had coined the name Big Bang in mockery. Sciama, on the other hand, was happy for Hawking to investigate the beginning of time. Hawking was studying the work of Roger Penrose, which proved that if Einstein's general theory of relativity is correct, at the heart of every black hole must be a point where space and time themselves break down, a singularity. Hawking realized that if time's arrow were reversed, the same reasoning would hold true for the universe as a whole. Under Sciama's encouragement, he worked out the maths and was able to prove it. The universe, according to general relativity, began in a singularity. Hawking was well aware, however, that Einstein didn't have the last word. General relativity, which describes space and time on a large scale, doesn't take into account quantum mechanics, which describes matter's strange behavior at much smaller scales. Some unknown theory of everything was needed to unite the two. For Hawking, the singularity at the universe's origin did not signal the breakdown of space and time. It signaled the need for quantum gravity. Luckily, the link that he forged between Penrose's singularity and the singularity at the Big Bang provided a key clue for finding such a theory. In 1974, Hawking proposed the theory that black holes emit radiation, which is now known as Hawking radiation. This groundbreaking idea had profound implications for our understanding of the nature of black holes. Black holes were a subject ripe for investigation in the early 1970s. Although Carl Schwarzschild had found such objects lurking in the equations of general relativity back in 1915, theoreticians viewed them as mere mathematical anomalies and were reluctant to believe they could actually exist. Before we continue our story, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Don't forget also to turn on the notification bell to be updated in our every uploads. Hawking is known for his theoretical contributions to science. But like any scientist, he didn't always get everything right the first time, and he had a reputation for placing and losing bets on scientific concepts. Hawking was known for bringing about a limited union between two very different fields, Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity and quantum theory. Hawking was awarded the CBE in 1982 and became a Companion of Honor in 1989. He received numerous awards and medals, including becoming a Fellow of the Royal Society and a member of the U.S. National Academy of Sciences. He was honored with the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 2009. Stephen Hawking was the University of Cambridge's Lucasian Professor of Mathematics from 1979 to 2009, a position once held by Sir Isaac Newton. A highly successful lecturer and author, from 1986, Hawking made use of an adaptive communication system including a speech synthesizer known as the Equalizer to combat ALS. Using the Equalizer, he authored books, scientific papers, and lectures, and was capable of communicating at the modest rate of about 15 words per minute. In 1988, Hawking published his best-selling book, A Brief History of Time, which aimed to make complex scientific concepts accessible to a general audience. The book became an international bestseller and brought him widespread recognition. His 1988 book, A Brief History of Time, set a Guinness World Record by staying on the Sunday Times bestseller list for 4.5 years. Still, the book's discussion of concepts like time, space, black holes, and the Big Bang proved to be a bit complex for non-scientists, and Hawking liked to joke that it was the least read, most purchased book in history. That's why in 2005, he published a more accessible version of the original called A Briefer History of Time. In 1975, he bet physicist Kip Thorne a penthouse subscription that an astronomical object known as Cygnus X-1 was not a black hole. Later, he also bet someone an encyclopedia over Hawking's claim that information gets lost in black holes, and wagered $100 that no one would ever discover the Higgs boson. Eventually, he lost all three of these bets. Despite these misplaced bets, Hawking did get a lot of things right. Among his first theoretical discoveries was his prediction that black holes should radiate, Larson says. But when he first came up with this idea and presented it to his colleagues, they thought it was rubbish. However, once his calculations for this theory went through scientific peer review, they found that yes, this is what the laws of physics as we understand them predict, she says. That black holes under the right circumstances should evaporate, should radiate. This scientific concept is now known as Hawking radiation, and remains one of his biggest contributions to cosmology. Despite his physical limitations, Hawking became a popular figure through his public lectures, appearances in documentaries, and interviews. His distinctive computer-generated voice, used to communicate due to his ALS, became iconic. He continued to write and publish books, including The Universe in a Nutshell, and The Grand Design, and remained an active speaker on scientific and popular platforms. Hawking believed that developing better technology was imperative for human survival, but he was also very concerned about the pursuit of artificial intelligence, or AI, when the theory of everything debuted in 2014. It received some criticism for its portrayal of Hawking's marriage to his first wife, Jane Wilde. Based on Wilde's writing about her life and marriage, the film offered a romantic, sentimental portrait of a woman who made sacrifices for her husband in the face of a very serious disease. In real life, things were a bit more complicated. Jane took on the task of caring for her husband along with three children as Hawking refused to talk with her about his illness. At one point, she described him as a child possessed of a massive and fractious ego. Stephen Hawking and his wife Jane Wilde separated in 1991. Hawking left Jane for his nurse, Elaine Mason, who became his second wife. From 2009, Hawking was almost completely paralyzed. In addition to his many books for adults, Hawking wrote several children's books with his daughter, Lucy, that combined science and adventure. These books all focus on a young boy named George, who learns about the universe by traveling around it. In the most recent one, George and the Blue Moon, George enters a Mars training program, fighting for survival in what feels like the Hunger Games set on the Red Planet, according to Hawking's own description. Hawking knew about the Hunger Games, as well as a few other things the kids are into these days. When asked about the significance of Zayn Malik leaving the band One Direction, he replied, "One day there may well be proof of multiple universes, and in that universe Zayn is still in One Direction." Stephen Hawking was a renowned theoretical physicist, cosmologist, and author who made significant contributions to the fields of theoretical physics and cosmology. In 2014, a movie based on Hawking's life was released. Called The Theory of Everything, the film drew praise from Hawking, who said it made him reflect on his own life. "Although I'm severely disabled, I have been successful in my scientific work," Hawking wrote on Facebook in November 2014. "I travel widely and have been to Antarctica and Easter Island, down in a submarine and up on a zero-gravity flight. One day, I hope to go into space." In August 2015, Hawking appeared at a conference in Sweden to discuss new theories about black holes and the vexing information paradox. Addressing the issue of what becomes of an object that enters a black hole, Hawking proposed that information about the physical state of the object is stored in 2D form within an outer boundary known as the event horizon. Noting that black holes are not the eternal prisons they were once thought, he left open the possibility that the information could be released into another universe. In 2007, at the age of 65, Hawking made an important step towards space travel. While visiting the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, he was given the opportunity to experience an environment without gravity. Over the course of 2 hours over the Atlantic, Hawking, a passenger on a modified Boeing 727, was freed from his wheelchair to experience bursts of weightlessness. Pictures of the freely floating physicist splashed across newspapers around the globe. Hawking was scheduled to fly to the edge of space as one of Sir Richard Branson's pioneer space tourists. In November of 2014, a film about the life of Hawking and Jane Wilde was released. The Theory of Everything stars Eddie Redmayne as Hawking and encompasses his early life and school days, his courtship and marriage to Wilde, the progression of his crippling disease and his scientific triumphs. In May 2016, Hawking hosted and narrated Genius, a six-part television series which enlists volunteers to tackle scientific questions that have been asked throughout history. On May 2, 2018, his final paper, titled A Smooth Exit from Eternal Inflation, was published in the Journal of High Energy Physics. Submitted 10 days before his death, the new report, co-authored by Belgian physicist Thomas Hertog, disputes the idea that the universe will continue to expand. Renowned physicist Stephen Hawking died on March 14, 2018, also known as Pi Day, at age 76. The scientist stands out for his significant contributions to the field of cosmology, the study of the origin and development of the universe. During his career, Hawking became a cultural icon who tried to make scientific concepts accessible to the wider community. Stephen Hawking's life and work continue to have a lasting impact on the scientific community and the public's understanding of the universe. His determination, intellect, and contributions to theoretical physics have left an indelible mark on the history of science. And that's the wrap of our story for today. Thank you guys for watching. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel, and also please press the notification bell to be updated in our every uploads.